Merchant's a big girl from her album Keep Your Courage, and that is featuring Adina from Davis as well, and it is Radio 1 album of the week. Make sure to check it out now. It is time to head over to Mark Bowes to see area news and weather forecast.
Thank you. Well, we have a nice range of high pressure on us now, so tonight will be calm, dry, with plenty of clear skies. It will be cold though. Temperature getting down from -1 to 3 degrees, so such a frost couldn't be ruled out. Saturday morning, a Saturday of dry, with some good sunny spells. The way to get on the Atlantic is a warm front will move over during the afternoon. The counties on the Atlantic coast will see cloudy creeks, but outbreaks of rain and drizzle from later in the morning. Staying mainly dry elsewhere, with highs of 9 to 13 degrees. Later Saturday evening, the rain will spread a little further east, with plenty of clouds following in behind. Not as cold over on Saturday though, but lows around 6 to 10 degrees. Sunday will start rather cloudy and dull with patchy light rain, but later in the day, clouds will break with some sunny spells developing as the rain begins to clear away. Mild at highs of 14 to 17 degrees, and staying cloudy Sunday night, with that southerly breeze bringing plenty of milder over the country and overnight lows, dropped around 8 to 10 degrees. Now, the theory forecast. I'll start by letting you know there's a small craft warning in operation. And the meteorological situation of 2100 hours, high pressure of 1027 hectopascals, centre west of Iberia, extends a ridge over Ireland. A front approaches from the west later. In the forecast for Irish coastal waters, from mizzen head to slime head, bear head, variable force 3 or less, soon becoming southerly force 5 or 6. The weather is fair, soon becoming cloudy with outbreaks of rain and drizzle. The visibility decreasing moderate or poor at times. And the forecast for Irish coastal waters from Fairhead, Cairnsville Point to Mizzenhead and for the Irish Sea, northwest force 3 or 4. variable force 3 or less, later increasing subtly to force 3 or 4. The weather's fair, but becoming cloudy later, and the visibility is good. Now let's look for further than 24 hours. Fresh to strong southerly winds, easing moderate in the east Sunday afternoon, and the weather is cloudy with occasional rain. And finally, the coastal reports from 11 p.m. this evening. Malin Head, west-northwest, 6 knots, fair, 24 miles, 1,011, and rising. Buoy N5, west to northwest, 16 knots. The visibility at Tusker Lighthouse is greater than 10 miles, 1,013, rising. Roches Point, northwest, 8 knots, fair, 26 miles, 1,014, rising. Valentia, northeast, 2 knots, fair, 15 miles, 1,015, rising. Balmullet, northwest, 6 knots, fair, 9 miles, 1,013, rising. And finally, Dublin Airport, west to northwest, 6 knots, fine, 16 miles, 1,012, rising. That's it for me for now. Have a great night, everyone.
I'm Martin Frawley. Air Force One, with US President Joe Biden on board, has departed from Ireland West Airport in Knock and County Mayo following the President's four-day trip to Ireland. Speaking to reporters at the airport, Mr. Biden said he has already made up his mind to run for the presidency again and will announce soon. Taoiseach Leo Varadkar was at the airport to formally bid farewell to Mr. Biden. Earlier, Mr. Biden addressed what the White House estimated was a crowd of 27,000 outside St. Lourdes Cathedral in Ballina. He told the crowd that this was the time to lay the foundations brick by brick for a better future for our kids and grandkids. Mr. Biden said that now is a time of enormous possibilities. The President made reference to his visit earlier in the day to Mayo Roscommon Hospital, where there was a plaque to his late son Beau, who died of cancer in 2015. Earlier at the Marion Shrine in Knock, Mr. Biden had an emotional chance meeting with former U.S. Army Chaplain Father Frank O'Grady, who performed the last rites on Beau Biden. Father O'Grady told RTÉ News that he had not seen Mr. Biden since that time.
Himself and his son Hunter and also his sister made the next chat for about 10 minutes. And gave me a big hug. Hunter gave me a big hug. And we talked a little bit about grief, about the fact that years can dissipate some grief, but there's some grief that take years and years to get over. And I think he's handling it okay. He was emotional today, and I told him, you know, that he was a person of great faith, and he said his faith sustains him.
introducing Mr. Biden in Ballinati shortly over at 12. Thanks, Mr. Biden, for what he said was his lifelong commitment to peace on the island of Ireland and efforts to build a better future here in America and the world. Mr. Radcliffe said Mayo is home to American companies to provide good jobs for so many and a new technological university which provides the greatest passport of all in education. The first meeting of the Citizens' Assembly on drug use is getting underway in Malahide in Dublin this morning. The Assembly has been established to consider the legislative policy and operational changes Ireland could make to significantly reduce the harmful impact of illicit drugs on society. Our social affairs correspondent, Albert Kennedy.
In February, the government announced the establishment of a Citizens' Assembly on drug use. 100 people, including 99 randomly chosen members of the public, led by Chairperson Paul Reid, will examine the issue of drug use in this country. They'll hear about the lived experience of people impacted by drugs, as well as their families and communities. They'll also look at international best practice. It's expected that they'll visit areas affected by drugs and hear from workers in addiction services on the ground. It's expected that a vote on recommendations by the Assembly will take place in October and that a final report will be submitted to government in December.
And that's it from the newsroom for now. Next news at 1.
Late Day on RTÉ.
Thank you.